This segment brought to you by Kansas Soybean Commission. Progress powered by Kansas farmers.
Back again.
Well, we're almost at St. Patrick's Day. That's our excuse for not wearing green. And St. Patrick's Day, way more fun than the Ides of March, is the 17th of March.
Yes.
So would we even have a good time at all if it weren't for the Irish?
For the Irish, yes.
Bless you. Bless their hearts for coming.
Well, I'm Irish.
I thought you said Chaffin was...
Well, the Chaffins, okay, there are two pronunciations, Chaffin, and there's Chaffin. And the Chaffin is from Ireland, and the Chaffin is from England. And the thing is, I mean, the families had...
So what did the Chaffins do?
And anyway, because there were brothers that came over during the potato famine, and of course emigrated to Ohio and then spread out all over the country, and because I think I have family down in Oklahoma and
run out may be more accurate, you know.
The Irish, there were a couple of immigrations, and one of course was due to the potato famine.
Right.
And anyway, they're just all over the country. But there was a movie, and I'm trying to think of the name of it now. It was about the Five Corners in New York, and that had a lot to do with, at that time, the Irish really were not welcome.
Yeah.
I mean, it was like, go home and the whole thing. Anyway.
Yeah. It's a very interesting history.
Yeah.
So let's take a look at the Irish in Kansas.
Yes, let's do.
According to the Kansas State Historical Society, in 1870, the majority of immigrants to Kansas came from the British Isles, and particularly Ireland. In 1871, Thomas Butler, an Irish priest in Leavenworth, wrote a pamphlet encouraging Irish people to move to Kansas. Extreme poverty and a lack of opportunity have often motivated the Irish to seek other shores, most famously during the Great Potato Famine. The impact of the famine on Kansas Irish population is documented by Father Butler in his discussion of the history of Catholicism in Kansas. When Catholic churches in the state increased from 3 in 1854 to 45 in 1871. The Wichita Eagles' Becky Tanner found many communities with Irish names, Chapman and Solomon in Dickinson County, Vesper in Lincoln County, and St. Benedict in Nemaha County. Patrick Doyle, an Irish immigrant who settled in Marion County, south of Florence, was the inspiration for Doyle Creek, Doyle Township, and the Doyle Post Office. Meade County has Irish Flats, and in Marshall County there is Irish Creek. Becky added that shortly after the Civil War, Irish labor helped build the Kansas Pacific Railroad and mined coal in southeast Kansas. Many of the Irish who came to Kansas during the mid to late 19th century did so because of a migration fueled by Ireland's potato famine and social and political turmoil. Perhaps the most recognizable influence of the Irish is in the University of Kansas mascot, the Jayhawk. The mythical bird of Irish origins that antagonized its prey and was adopted to describe Kansans during the border wars, the original border wars of the 1850s and 1860s. And now, dear viewers, a toast to our Irish roots. Tarwater Farm and Home has been family-owned and operated since its beginning in 1978. What you need for farm and agriculture, lawn and garden, clothing and footwear, and so much more. You'll be surprised at what you'll find in this huge store. They have what you need, and lots of it. So come take a look. You'll discover that customer service is first and foremost. Always has been with the Tarwaters. Tarwater Farm and Home, 4107 North Topeka Boulevard.